Okay, let's go. Oh shit. Oh my god. Oh, hey there guys, I didn't see you. I was checking out one of my oldest videos, and Jesus Christ, this shit it's f***ing terrible. I mean, there is terrible, and then there is f***ing terrible, and this stuff is f***ing terrible. Wait, am I allowed to curse on YouTube? Please allow me to show you a short clip of what my oldest movies look like.
However, they realized that—
as you can see, it's pretty terrible because I didn't know how to properly set up my camera, I didn't know how to properly set up my audio, and well, I didn't have any lighting equipment. But the most gruesome part of making these videos was the editing process, because I had to look at my own video, and as you saw, it wasn't really visually appealing, and I especially hated listening to my own voice. And I think this is a situation which a lot of people recognize. Who hasn't had these moments where you just hear yourself on a recording and you just think, is that me? In my previous video, I already explained why we hate looking at our own pictures or videos. And in this video, I'm just going to explain why we hate listening to recordings of our own voice. If you're new to the channel, hi there, my name is Willem, and as you can see, I make videos where I talk about why we hate ourselves. And sometimes I talk about other psychological stuff as well. If you liked this video, if you thought it was fun or educative, please leave a like, share it with your friends. It really helps my channel grow. If you have feedback, positive or negative, drop it in the comments. And of course, don't forget to subscribe. That being said, welcome to Brains Applied. Whenever we listen to a YouTube movie or someone else's voice, we listen to the sound waves in the air. These sound waves make our eardrums vibrate. The eardrum then starts to move the tiny bones in our ears, which are called malleus, incus, and stapes. Together they form the ossicles, which in their turn make the membrane at the end of our cochlea vibrate. The cochlea is a spiral-shaped cavity that is filled with a fluid. And together with the fluid, the little hairs on the inner walls of the cochlea start to move along with the sound waves, and they trigger our auditory nerves. And that, my friends, is how you and I hear regular noise. But when you are talking yourself, the vocal cords in your throat start to vibrate, and they don't just make the air vibrate, they also make your bones vibrate a tiny bit. And through your bones, the sound waves are conducted towards your inner ear. And there, they have an effect on the fluid in your cochlea. Our bones, however, are specifically good at conducting the sound waves with a lower frequency, with as a consequence that your own voice will always sound different and lower in your own head than it does in reality. Now, if you've seen my previous video, you're probably thinking, yes, I know where this is going. It's that mere exposure effect again. We prefer the things that we get exposed to more often, so as a consequence, we prefer our own voice as we hear it in our head. And my answer to that is, not really, actually. Let me explain. People are really, really, really bad at recognizing their own voice. Some studies found that only 38% of the people can immediately identify their own voice from a bunch of different voices. And this allows us to do some pretty cool experiments. In one study, researchers let their participants rate the attractiveness of different voices. What the participants didn't know, however, was that the researchers had also included a previously made recording of the participants' own voice. It turned out that the participants consistently rated their own voice as more attractive than the voices of others. And they also gave themselves higher ratings than they were given by others. Or in other words, you don't dislike your own voice, you actually like it more than other voices. That is, until you are being told that this is your own voice. That's how the mirror exposure effect changes our behavior in this case. So if you don't know that you are listening to yourself, the difference between how you sound in your own head and the big, brutal reality is big enough to make it hard to identify yourself. But it's still small enough for the mirror exposure effect to kick in. Making your voice, with which you are more familiar, more attractive in comparison to other voices. The next question is obviously, why do we only hate our own voice when we are told that it's our own voice? When you hear yourself talk on a recording, you become more aware of all the tiny imperfections in the way you talk. The little stutters, the intonation that's slightly off, and all those eeny meeny tiny things that just happen accidentally. But while you are talking, your brain doesn't actively notice these imperfections. And this happens because of a very simple reason. Prior to speaking up, our brain makes a template of what we want to say. This template is called an efference copy. But when we finally start talking, the part of the auditory cortex that focuses on recognizing voices decreases its activity. It's just active enough to compare what we say to the efference copy and to make sure that we don't say anything wrong. But it won't notice all the details because you already know what you sound like. So evolutionary, it would be a waste of energy to listen to all these details. And not doing so frees up more processing power to listen to what is happening in our environment. The consequence of this is that when we hear ourselves talk on a recording, we just don't sound as perfect as we thought we sounded in our own head. But please, just remember that your voice probably isn't as weird as you think it is. And if you really want to get used to your own voice, act like me. Start a YouTube channel or a podcast or something else which forces you to listen to your own voice all the time. And that, my friends, is all I wanted to tell you today. I hope you liked this video. If you did, press the like button. And of course, don't forget to hit the subscribe button and the notification bell so you receive a 100% free notification next time when I upload a new video. And I will see you guys later.